Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Gabriel, I'm a structural engineer. I hope you all enjoyed your holidays and started fresh this year. And today's video a little bit more informative. There won't be any calculations. I'm gonna talk about the four conventional house building systems used in Australia. And they are timber frame, brick veneer, double brick, and concrete block. It's so great to have you here again. And I hope this video is helpful to you. The first typical construction method I'll touch upon is timber frame, which is the most common construction system for houses in Australia. So the frame is composed of a large number of small elements working parallel. So we've got several rafters working parallel for this roof framing, and below we've got studs working parallel as well. And the way of which this type of structure transmits gravity loads from the roof down to the footing is through the floors and wall frames. So the wall frame consists of top and bottom plates, studs, noggings, and these beams at the openings are called lintels. So besides gravity loads, this lightweight framing also needs to withstand wind loads. And these lateral loads are distributed between bracing walls by the floor diaphragms and then down to the ground. And you can see here in this image structural plywood that provides bracing to the building against wind loads. So the house can be suspended on a system of joists and beams as shown in this photo, or the house can be sitting straight on a slab on ground. As an engineer, you're going to use AS1684 to design this type of structure for residences alongside a couple of other standards like AS2870 residential slabs and footings, AS1170 and 4055 for design loads. So the process of construction of the main structures begins with the footings and the sanitary drainage under the slab on ground, if you have a slab on ground, of course. And the next step is to lay the concrete floors or bearers and joists. And then the wall frame is erected. And finally, the roof frame is constructed. Also, roof sarking is applied and the cladding is attached to the battens. And following that, the construction process goes from installing windows and doors to the installation of plumbing pipes, electrical wiring, and so on. The second typical construction method is brick veneer. The walls for this method of construction consists of a brick facade fixed to a timber frame on the inside. So the layer of brick is fixed to the timber frame with brick ties regularly spaced. There's a cavity of typically 40 millimeters between the frame and the brick wall, which acts as a moisture barrier and provides insulating properties. Remember, the timber frame does all the structural load bearing work. Therefore, the stud wall is holding up the house and not the brick. As an engineer, you're going to use AS1684 as well as AS4773 to design this type of structure for residences alongside a couple of other standards, as I mentioned before. The stages of construction begin with building the footings and sanitary drainage under the slab. The footing could be either a ground beam, where you pour the slab on ground at the same time, or a strip footing, which has separate pours. So you pour the strip footing, and then later on, you pour the slab. The brick base can be constructed up to the floor level. And next, you're gonna lay the floor, whether it's concrete or timber. So if you're building a timber floor, you will probably have brick piers to hold up the bearers and joists. Following that, the timber walls are erected, including the bracings. The roof framing is constructed. And as previously stated, sarking will be laid and then the tiles or sheet cladding is attached. The windows and exterior doors door frames are installed, and finally the brick walls are constructed. The third conventional house building system is double brick, which consists of two brick walls standing side by side with a cavity between and tied together with cavity ties. And for this reason, this construction system is also called cavity brick construction. The internal partitions can be studs, brick, or concrete blocks, and rendered or lined with wallboard. As an engineer, you're going to use AS4773 to design this type of structure for residences alongside a couple of other standards. So again, the first step in the construction process is to lay the reinforced footings and install the sanitary drainage. You can form a strip footing and a slab separately, or a ground beam and slab together, as I mentioned before. The bricks are laid up to the slab floor level, or when using timber floor, up to the bottom of the bearer height. Following that, the floor is laid and the inner leaf of the double wall is built with the windows and exterior doors built in. The internal partitions are constructed and the roof is erected. The internal linings are attached and all interior doors fitted and finishing work carried out. At the same time, the outer brick leaf can be built. The last system is blockwork construction. Concrete block construction usually uses 190 millimeters thick block walls as external walls, while the internal partitions are constructed in timber or 90 or 140 millimeters blocks. However, if you're reinforcing the internal walls, you will have to use 140 or 190 millimeters blocks. The external block walls can be either reinforced or unreinforced. And when it comes to reinforced masonry walls, usually N12 or N16 bars are placed in specific vertical cores, bond beams, and lintels. So as previously stated, the engineer can use AS4773 to design this type of structure for residences alongside a couple of other standards. Also, you can go to the website of the Concrete Masonry Association of Australia, and they've got several design manuals that you can use. The process of building begins with the footing construction, as well as laying any block work below slab level. The slab is prepared with all relevant drainage and plumbing services installed. The blockwork is constructed with reinforcing, anchor bolts, plumbing and electrical conduits installed. And finally, the concrete is poured to vertical cores with reinforcement bars, lintels and bond beam. So the top plates will be fixed to the block walls if required, and then internal partitions and roof framing constructed. Again, the builder is going to attach the sarking and cladding to the roof. He's going to render the exterior walls if required, paint it, and install windows and doors. These are some of the most popular construction methods in the country, and they vary in popularity among the states due to material or labor availability, climate, prices, and you can also find houses made of a system of reinforced concrete beams and columns. Modular homes are getting pretty popular as well, light steel framed house, container house. There's a multitude of construction systems. If you're interested in a specific system, just leave a comment below and we can have a chat about it, or maybe even make a video about it. And anyway, thanks again, and I'll see you next time.